Welcome back to the channel, it's The Preventers here guys, and welcome back to another Marvel Future Fight video. In today's video guys, we're going to be giving you guys the ultimate guide or cheat sheet to the Goblin Queen Epic Quest. This was given to me by a friend, so big shout out to @DailyMarvelFutureFight. I'll make sure to leave a link to his channel in the description. He actually gave this to me, and it's really helped me throughout my Epic Quest experience, so I think it'll really help you guys, whether or not you have started it or not. I think it's very helpful, so I want to share it with you guys. I did put it in the Discord, but I know not everybody's in the Discord, so I wanted to make sure that I made a video dedicated to it as well, breaking it down for you guys. So without further ado, let's take a look. So we're given this sheet is made by BaconX on Discord. He's actually one of Cynic Alex's mods on Discord, I believe. So huge shout out to him as well for putting this together. It's really helpful. And like I said, I think it would be really helpful for you guys too, whether you've started it or not. So let's dive right in. So first off, there is a lot of breaking it down. There's a lot of search missions, for dimension mission in this epic quest. I'm sure most of you guys, if you've played it, know or have heard, because there's been a lot of complaining about it. But basically you are giving research where you have to find 30, items. It's usually something random. And you can only do it by playing dimension mission. Now, the thing about that is that you're going to want to make sure that you're playing on difficulty 6. As much as it's not going to get you the contribution rewards, it is going to save you a lot of energy, and believe me, you're going to have to do this dimension search many times, so please make sure you're running on difficulty 6. It helps a lot. The average drop rate is the same no matter what stage you play at. So stage 6 is going to be your best bet, so you can save the most amount of energy and still gather the rewards. Now, there's of course a deluxe pack, you guys already know that. Something else that you really need to know is that if you get Havoc from 60 to 70 on your own, you don't get any of the rewards back. So just play out the epic quest how it tells you, and then you'll get the rewards that you need. You can fully upgrade him once you're done. You don't have to wait after that. Mission rewards is basically just breaks down all the rewards that you're going to get, a lot of different stuff, especially if you unlock the deluxe pack. Again, that's 7,700 crystals, so it is more expensive than previous deluxe packs, so keep that in mind when you make your choice, and please make sure that if you decide to buy this deluxe pack, wait until the anniversary or at least a crystal spending event so you can get more rewards back, because you are spending a whole lot of crystals. And you don't want to miss out on extra rewards if you're going to already spend this much crystals. So what do I need? These are the character lists of what you're going to need. You're going to need 5-star Omega and 5-star Cyclops. Hopefully a lot of you guys already have them built. You do get bios, and as you clear the Epic Quest, there is a game mode where you can get 10 of their bios daily. So if you really do need their bios, they are available there. You're also going to need 5-star Exodus. I haven't seen this just yet at the point where I'm at, but apparently you do. The only way he can be acquired is as a shifter in the Brother in Crisis. You also get him unlocked from clearing a quest. Sorry about that. You also get him from a quest from the actual Epic Quest. But to get him to 5-star, it's going to be best that you use rank up tickets. You're going to need him at tier 2 anyways if you're going to upgrade Madeline Pryor. Or if you're going to acquire Madeline Pryor. So might as well invest in some tickets for him anyways. You're going to need to spend some tier 2 materials. You're going to need 2 rank 6 black antimatter, 2 rank 5 antimatter, 4 rank 4, and 6 rank 3. This is equivalent to 3,800 rank 1 BAM. So this is assuming that you use all the BAM given to you as rewards as well. So that's what you're going to need in total for this whole epic quest. You're also going to need 1,400 Chaos Norn Stones, 800 Phoenix Feathers. You're also going to need more Phoenix Feathers for Havoc's gears, though, so make sure you save those. If you haven't been watching our live streams, it's actually something we've been running into, is running out of Phoenix Feathers, so please save those. You're going to need a lot of them for this epic quest. You also need 800 Murkranian crystals, so make sure you have those as well. Some other tier 3 materials as well. You're going to need 10 Blast Titan books for Havoc, of course, 780 EOD. You also need some tiny and component packs. For just his gears, and then 1,200 cosmic cube fragments, and then some other small rewards that you or materials that you're gonna have to give up is 300 Murkranian shards, 500 dimension debris, and 500 gear pits. Most of you guys should have that, so it should be all good. You're gonna need a lot of energy, and I mean a lot of energy for this epic quest. There's a lot that you have to do, so make sure that you save up enough Because if not, you're going to find yourself stuck at many points throughout this. You're also going to need at least 35 minimum battle timeline battle. So it's going to take you up to 4 days if you're not recharging. You're also going to have a challenge at the very end where you need to win timeline battle 10 times. So you got to keep that in mind as well. And then, of course, if you want to unlock Madeline Pryor, you're going to need the following characters at Tier 2. We've already covered this before. But just in case you don't know, you're going to need Havoc, Exodus, Rachel Summers, Kid Omega, Cyclops, Cable, and Hope Summers, of course. A couple other notes. You're limited to 3 times for the Brother in Crisis mission. So there is a you're actually going to have to clear this 5 times total. So no matter what you do, even if you rush through the whole Epic Quest, it's going to take you 2 days minimum. Because you're going to only be able to clear it 3 times. Then you have to wait a day or a reset to clear it the next 2 times. And then the most helpful part of this whole sheet here that I would say is a breakdown of literally every single mission, the rewards that you get as the free Epic Quest and the Deluxe. And it basically just tells you everything you need. So the first mission is chapter starts off with Dimension Mission cleared 3 times, use 50 energy, and so on and so on. It lists all 55 total challenges that you have to do to complete the Epic Quest. And to finally be able to tier 3 Havoc and finish it out. So yeah, this part is really helpful because you can really, like I said, if you are already playing the Epic Quest, you can go find here where you're at. So let's see, I'm on 41. I'm like here, and then I can look at, okay, so next I'm going to have to be upgrading Havoc's gears multiple times. I'm going to have to clear ready for battle 3 times. I'm going to have to research Macranon shards, 500 of them, so I need to make sure I save that, blah, blah, blah. You can basically plan out what you need and make sure that you save it so that you maximize your time spent on the Epic Quest. Now, I'll make sure, like I said, to leave a link in this in the description of the video. Like I said, this thing is really helpful. Big shout out again to AddDailyMar Future Fight and BaconYX, for creating this. And one more thing I want to talk about before we wrap up today's video. Is just a realistic timeline for finishing this Epic Quest. Now, if you're a whale, they're probably getting it done in 2 days, like I said, because you can just recharge. If you have plenty of energy sitting around, you can probably do that as well. If you have plenty of Phoenix Feathers, you'll be fine. But realistically, guys, for as a casual player as myself, it's actually taken me a little bit longer. It's probably going to end up taking me 5 days to finish out the Epic Quest. We will be live tomorrow for day number 4, so make sure to tune in. But it's going to take me at least 5 days just because of my Phoenix Feathers. But I'd say if you have all the materials saved up, if you have everything that is listed here, then it should probably take you 3 or 4 days at maximum. It depends on the timeline battle. It depends if you can get those 10 wins. If you can, then it'll probably be 3 days. If not, it'll probably end up turning into 4 days. As long as you play it right and save your materials and make sure that you know what's to come. And what missions you have to do up next. So yeah, I would say a realistic timeline if you're like trying to maximize, it's gonna be 4 to 5 days. If you are just casually playing through it, then I'd say a week or two should be enough time for you to finish this Epic Quest. Again, you're gonna need a lot of rank up tickets for like Exodus and stuff too, so that may push you back as well. If you don't have those available, then you may have to wait a month or so for some availability to be able to buy those rank up tickets in the pre-update quests and stuff like that. Now, as far as buying the deluxe pack, because this is another question I've been asked, and I want to just close on this for the video, is people were asking me, is it worth buying, and if so, when should I buy it, and what's a realistic timeline for a casual player to save up enough crystals, like bare minimum, when should I buy it? And so my answer to the first question is it worth it? Right now, not really. Hope Summers is the only meta character. Other than that, these other characters are stuck at tier 3 or at tier 2. And until they get their upgrades, then it's not going to be really worth it for casual players. I do think that they are going to get their upgrades in the next 2 months, though. I think Madeline will get her tier 4 and Exodus will get his tier 3. Then by then, I think it'll be worth it. So I think 2 months is probably a good amount of time to save up crystals. It's also going to put us around the anniversary date. And like I told you guys, if you're going to buy the deluxe, I think the best time is the anniversary to, take, the maximum rewards back for the crystal spending event. So that's my realistic timetable, I would say, for you guys. It's also very realistic to me as a more casual player. Even with the yearly crystal sub that I bought at the beginning of this year, it's still taking me a while to save up that much crystals. And I think by the anniversary, I should have enough, even though I'm going to be spending some on uniforms as they come out every update. I still think I'll be able to save up. One of the biggest things is just waiting for those Mega Tier 2 tickets, because I'm going to have to buy one for Exodus and for Rachel. And of course, we only get one of those a month for free. So unless you pay, it's going to take you at least 2 months to get those characters as well. And then I know that some people don't have Rachel unlocked either, which is a problem. That can also take you a while because you're going to have to spend 4,500 crystals. So there's a lot of things that vary in this epic quest, guys. But what I can tell you is to just take it slow, maximize your time on it, you know, maximize with this sheet on how much time you spend on it and planning for it. But at the same time, don't rush it. None of these characters are super meta. This is sort of just a future investment for yourself if you do want to buy the deluxe and if you do want to sort of invest in finishing this epic quest. It's really just a future investment, guys, so there's no need to rush it. However long it takes you is however long it takes you. But I hope, with that said, that this sheet really helps you and that my advice really helps you figure out your times table on when you're going to get this done and when you should have it done. And yeah, overall, I hope this video really helped. And if it did, as always, guys, please consider leaving a like and subscribing to the channel. It really helps me out. Again, we're going to be live tomorrow for day number 4. We only got 2 more days of this, and we should be done with the free version of the Epic Quest 100%. So please tune on in. Come talk to us. We have a great time there every live stream, and I look forward to seeing you guys. But for today's video, guys, that will do it. Have a great rest of your day, and we'll see you all in the next one. Peace out.